Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, A Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Off screen, I ran back here. Backtracking. We really didn't have to do that in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. I hope there's not too much of that in this game. It didn't take me too long to get back here. I didn't get in any battles, I just ran past all the monsters. We're supposed to get this book. Did something happen over at the mountain pass? My fellow soldiers ran towards the castle. I can't answer you. Well, the book might be in the castle, or it might be in the library, because the library has books. Avin says, wow, there are mountains of books. Yeah, we've been here before. Avin says, how can we find a single book? You know, the Dewey Decimal System? Marty says, it's too much work. Let's ask the librarian first. If he doesn't know, we can ask the scholar in the back room. Hello, Marty. Which book are you looking for today? It's an ancient manuscript called The Book of Life. Do you know about it? The Book of Life? Well, I've never heard of it. However, we have some unindexed ancient manuscripts in the back. Why don't you ask Professor Logos? As always, he's doing his research in the back room today. Okay. This girl is still asleep. Wake up. Let's talk to her too. What? What's wrong? Marty says, I see you are familiar with this library. Have you ever seen a book called The Book of Life? The Book of Life? Well, sorry, but I've never heard of it. You should ask the librarian or Professor Logos. Yep, it's down to the professor. There's the only one else here in this library as well. Hello, Marty. How's your study going? Well, I didn't come here to study today. Do you know an ancient manuscript called The Book of Life, Professor? The Book of Life? Why are you looking for such a book? So, you've heard of it? I know the name. It's written in the ancient holy letters. They say the esoteric mantra of Durga, the spirit god, is documented. But I heard it was lost a long time ago. Is there a copy of it anywhere? Not as far as I know. The great library and cathedral might have had one, but that is gone now. Cathedral. Is that the cathedral? I don't think it's the same cathedral in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. It might be. Or maybe I'm thinking of the great cathedral, not the great library in cathedral. Marty says, I see. We're in trouble then. May I ask you why you're looking for that book? Actually, the Syamseal Gang is looking for it. Marty told Logos what had happened. That's a grave matter. By the way, I'm surprised that the Syamseal Gang is smart enough to know about the Book of Life. Of course, the issue is why they want it. Marty says, I don't think they can get a lot of roses for it. I believe there are other reasons they want it that we don't know yet. Muse says, we have no time to explain it at length. Innocent villagers are being threatened with their lives as we speak. If we can't find the book, we must think of some other way. What other way? Asks Avin. How about this? Says Mile. The book is written in the holy letters, right? I don't think anyone can read it easily. How about bringing a book of a similar title, also written in the holy letters? We may be able to deceive the Syamseal Gang for a while. Do you think it'll work? Says Avin. Honestly, I think the chances are slim. But at least we should be able to buy some time until we rescue the hostages. I agree, says Muse. We must do whatever possible to save the villagers. Marty says, Professor, do you know any suitable book? As a matter of fact, I do. That's great, says Avin. I want to know what's behind that locked door. Life, life, yes. Here it is, The Bonds of Life. The Bonds of Life, says Morty. What kind of book is it? It's an ancient soap opera. Actually, the story is quite entertaining. Avin says, I suddenly lost confidence in this plan. Don't worry, the binding is old, so nobody will be able to tell at a glance. Muse says, we can't thank you enough. Let's bring the book to the village. They borrowed Bonds of Life. Huh. Be careful not to let them find out the truth. Let me in here. Now, is this something we can read, or it's written in holy letters, it says. Bonds of Life, Rodriguez. Oh, elegant maiden. Ancient melodrama kept at the Royal Library, said to be very entertaining. Oh, we can't read it. We can't read the rest of it. Alright. Let's go back. Have you found the book you wanted? Marty says, well, kind of, but I'm not sure. What is it? We will not tell you. Have you found what you were looking for? You don't deserve an answer. I saw many soldiers go out of the castle towards the highway. Professor Morty, I have a bad feeling about this. Oh, he's the professor, Morty? You don't have anything to worry about, he says. Hey, stop, says the soldier. The highway became completely closed. They say even guild adventurers aren't allowed to pass. I can't let you through. What? Avin says, hey, hold on. We have work that's under request from the element leader. But still, this is a decision made by General Dieran. I can't go against his orders. Who's General Dieran? Says Mile. Marty says, he's the commander of the king's army. He's a hero that's put a stop to rebel forces many times in the past. It's going to be hard to protest through the guild. Mew says, man, that rockhead. I have no other choice but to play our ace of spades. Muse? Says Avin. What is she talking about? Mew says, listen very carefully. I am... Huh? Says a soldier. Whoa! Yeah, she's the princess. It's a Mila, I forget her name. Are you satisfied now? No. I can't believe that. Now that you mention it. No, I can't be fooled. Mew says, you don't have to believe me if you don't want to. But if you choose not to, you understand what would happen to you, right? Mew smiled sweetly. I like her. Okay. Please, go through as you please. I like people who know what's best for them. What just happened? Says Avin. Don't worry about it. Now we're free to roam the highway. Sir, please be careful on your trip. Okay. Should we fight some monsters? Let's fight some monsters. Nice. I like when the pet is angry. Not at me, but at the enemy. Deadly time. Flamethrower on this cluster B. Oh, is throwing fireball on us. 1 point. Could use a little healing. I know to go all around these bridges. There's three of them, I think. I only know where to go because we just came back this way. At least it's not that far. Knowing where to go helps. We will fight you. Avoid that whip. I like the beat. Fast drums. Another re-belief. I like the song. This music grows on me as I play. We'll fight you too. This might be the last enemy. We'll fight. Scouting birds. Scout this. That's a disadvantage of going before your enemy. You're like running past that one to get to the other one. Avin levels up. Level 6 and Mile as well. Mile has mastered Refresh. What does that do? A spell to remove all abnormal status, effective against poison, sleep, etc. Awesome. I approve. Anyway, fight one more. That one didn't even want to fight us. Yeah, because we leveled up. Take this. Whoa. Missed. Ouch. Missed. Wow, Marty is so close. Wow. Is this where they are sitting? Oh no, they're up even more. They're up here. Let's fight this thing. I wanna get see if we can level up Marty. Got a hot foot. Yay, Marty. Level 6 as well. Good. All right, let's go in a save. Just in case anything horrible happens. Avin says, "Here's the ancient manuscript they're demanding." Like, yelling it. The general says, "Oh." Muse says, "Oops." The general says, "Your Highness." Haha, they recognized her. Muse says, haha. "Your Highness, Princess Muldeen." That's the name I was trying to remember. These guys have no idea, though. "General Diran, I see you're well." Avin says, "What's going on?" Miles says, "Did he just say princess?" "You, be quiet," says Diran. "This is the first princess of Elfilden. Muldeen Uriel Sylviana Esmelas." Quite a mouthful. Avin says, "What? Princess?" says Mile. Marty says, "I knew she wasn't who she said she was, but don't look at me like that. Actually, Muse is the acronym of my real name." "Oh yeah. Muldeen, Uriel, whatever, blah blah blah." "Princess," the general says. Yeah, he's loud. Muse says, "Don't shout at me. Your voice is loud enough. I hear you clearly." "No, you don't. Do you know how worried the king has been since you disappeared?" "My father is not disturbed by a small thing like that. He always says the royal family should travel far and wide to broaden their knowledge." "But that doesn't mean you should get involved in this siege by the Syamseal Gang. There must be a limit." Avin says, "I can see you have a complicated situation, but this isn't the time to argue. We should rescue the people of Tibri first." "Shut up. This is a matter that affects our country's future." He's so rude. "To begin with, how come a kid like you is accompanying the princess?" "Are you calling me a kid, you bearded old man?" "She's the one who followed us." "Bearded old man?" Miles says, "Avin gets mad so easily." I like it. Marty says, "They do have that in common." Muse says, "You two, cut it out. Avon's right. We shouldn't be wasting our time arguing." "But Princess..." "General Diran, what is your role? Isn't it to lead the renowned king's army of Filden to drive away the enemies that threaten our people? You mustn't be babysitting me now." "Yes, but the people of Tibri are suffering. Do your job." I understand. I will not say any more. But once this case is over, I'll surely get you and take you back." "Don't worry. I won't run or hide. So how's the situation? Can you give me a detailed report? Yes, ma'am. The Syamseal Gang has a small group of about 10. Oh, that's all? However, they are taking the villagers hostage, so we can't attack them carelessly. How are the hostages? All hostages, including the village chief, are captured in a civilian house in the northwest side of the village. They say they'll burn the house if we go in. Muse says, they're such cowards. In this kind of situation, we usually keep their attention at the front while mounting a sneak attack from the back. However, the village is surrounded by steep cliffs. Heavily armed soldiers will inevitably draw the enemy's attention before they can approach the house. We've been racking our brains for an effective strategy. Avin says, we'll do the sneak attack. All we need is to sneak in from the back and free the hostages, right? Right, says Marty. It's a perfect job for the adventurers. We don't carry heavy arms to slow us down. Darren says, it's not a bad idea. However, Fatima, the ringleader, is a shrewd woman. I don't know if they'll give us a chance. We have bait, says Mile. This is a fake copy of the Book of Life that they're demanding. Mile handed Bonds of Life to General Darren. Well, this might work. I'll bring the book to them myself. I may be able to bring their guard down a little. Muse says, I'll help with the freeing of the hostages. Princess! He's yelling again. It is a tradition of the Filden family to lead the people in a time of crisis. I can bring the manuscript to them myself, if you like. Alright, I won't say anything. Please be careful. Marty says, let's confirm the plan. First, the general contacts the enemy leader. While he's keeping the attention of the enemy, we'll sneak in and free the hostages. Darren says, as soon as the hostages are freed, we'll send troops to arrest all Syamseal Gang members. Element leader, I'm counting on you. Yes, sir. Avin says, let's begin the operation. Oh, wow, here we go. Darren says, listen, Syamseal Gang. I'm General Darren of the King's Army of Filden. I brought the ancient manuscript you requested. A voice says, the Honorable General himself brought it, huh? That's pretty cool. Where is your boss? Says Darren. The henchman says, don't worry, I'll take you to her. Follow me. Can you really sneak in that easily? Well, there's Fatima. Welcome, General Darren. It is an honor that you yourself came. You must be tired from hiking in the Ziziki mountain path. You're not young enough to work that hard. You are the notorious Fatima. You deceived us with false information. Fatima says, deceiving enemies with false information is the basic strategy of battle. It's your fault that you underestimated us. Who's that girl? She's just our insurance to make sure you don't do anything stupid. You haven't done anything to her, have you? The Syamseal Gang doesn't do anything without a reason, so as long as you don't give us reason, she'll be fine. But that girl has been messing us up with her constant chatter. Shannon says... Okay, this is a new person. Oh, what a destiny. My wonderful yet short life is going to end because of these bloodless villains. They have no blood? But I won't give up. I know without a doubt that my prince will come rescue me. Fatima says, see? Tyrion says, looks like you have your hands full. Avin says, I see a guardsman. Knock him out, says Muse. Dirin says, "First, release the girl, or I won't give you this manuscript." "You think you can negotiate? We have the upper hand. You need to give us the Book of Life first." Oh, knocked him out, I guess. And burst down the door. Avin says, "Hi there. We're here to rescue you." Morty says, "No need to make haste. Please run away quietly." No need to make haste. But then run away. That makes no sense. Running away is making haste. Yeah, they're making haste over there. Fatima says, "I don't take taking a life lightly, but a little sacrifice is unavoidable in plans like this. If you don't hand us the Book of Life, something bad is going to happen to you, the girl, and the other hostages." "What is your plan?" says Dirin. "We don't want to spend the rest of our lives as one miserable gang. We want to do something bigger. To be able to do so, we really need that book." Meanwhile, Shannon's mother saying, "Please help! My daughter! My daughter was kidnapped!" Avin says, "What?" "Dang," says Marty, "there are more hostages." Yeah, they thought all the hostages were in one building. Fatima says, "Well, it's time to make your decision. Do it!" Oh, they knocked the book out of it. General Dirin says, "Ugh." "Ha ha ha. It's your fault. You wouldn't have had to go through any pain if you had just given us the book." Fatima picked up the ancient manuscript. The life's... "What the hell is this?" The henchman says, "What's wrong, Fatima?" "This book is a fake. You try to trick us. Do you think I couldn't read the sacred letters?" "Guys, make him stand up." This is exciting. Miles says, "What should we do, Avin? What about the girl?" Henchman, "We're not gonna let you get away." Meanwhile, Fatima says, "You should have brought the real book. General, I don't think you're going to make it out of here alive, do you?" "Death doesn't scare me." "Really? Fine." Element leader says, "General Dirin!" Fatima says, What happened to the guards?" Element leader says, "General, are you alright?" Yeah. Barely. "I'm very impressed, General Dirin. I never would have thought that you would have been the bait." "Everyone, retreat!" Shannon yells, "No! Help me, my prince!" I'm not even pressing buttons here. Mew says, "General!" "Ugh. I'm sorry, Your Highness. Our girl was taken." "What?" says Muse. Element leader says, "I'm sorry. We lost them after entering the woods." "Oh, shoot," says Avin. "How clever they are," says Muse. Morty says, "Calm down, guys. It's not over yet." Element leader, "Where do you think they would retreat to?" "I think the only place they could hide around here is Zaziki Cave." "Let's go in with all the units," says Muse. Marty says, "I don't think it's a good idea. If the army moves in, the girl's life will be at risk. It's better to sneak in quietly." "What are you going to do?" says Dirin. Avin says, "Leave it up to us. Remember, we are adventurers." Miles says, "Their boss doesn't know our faces either." "I'll go with you," says Muse. "Your Highness!" Muse says, "You guard the area. There might be remnants of the Syamseal Gang. This is the order from me as the first princess." "Yes, ma'am." Okay, that music was driving me insane. Alright, let's look around a little bit. Oh, wow. Alright, let's talk to all these people. "Please, feel assured about the villagers' safety." We will guard here. Please take caution. Darren? Your Highness, please be careful. If you get in a dangerous situation, run away. Who's this? Chief Rudo. Please, you are the only ones we can count on. By the way, you look tired. Before you venture after the Syamseal Gang, why don't you take a rest at our house? I will. Just, first I want to talk to everybody. Please don't overwork yourself. Yeah, let's rest. I hit it by mistake anyway. This is the only way I can repay you. Please come by whenever you feel tired. Village chief's wife says, "Oh, what can I do? Please help, princess." Are they still gathered around here? Okay. Let's see what this says. South is capital Filden. We knew that. Shannon's mother says, "She's pretty reckless, so I'm afraid she will get into trouble by making the Syamseal Gang upset. I hope they won't do anything horrible to her. Please, please rescue her." Is that her father? Yeah. "Please, I beg you, please save my daughter. Please, princess, take me with you." Mew says, "Please don't worry. I promise I'll save your daughter. In the name of Uriel and Sylviana." That's her middle names. "Where did those names come from?" asks Avin. Miles says, "They are her middle names, right?" Marty says, "Uriel was the late queen. She was Muse's mother. Sylviana is the king's mother. That is, she is Muse's grandmother." Interesting. "I trust you. Please save my daughter." So we stayed in their house, we talked to them. "I don't feel like doing business today, but I opened the store anyway. Come around to the front of the counter." Yeah, they don't like when we're on the wrong side of the counter. "Welcome. There are many useful things for sale here." Let's do the exchange thing. Rare potion and rarer potion. That's 100 hit points. SP Arcanum 1. Yeah, we have that. Antidote. Instantly neutralized poison in body. Grown in the church's herbal garden. Stimulant. Brewed from over a dozen herbs, its strong smell awakens the unconscious. Blaze Charm is a talisman containing fireball inside. Gives fire damage to the entire enemies. Tornado Charm is talisman containing aerial bliss inside. Gives wind damage to the surrounding. Gravel Charm. Talisman containing stone blast inside. Gives earth damage over a limited area. And Star Ring is a magic ring that emits the Venus's light. Increases overall spell power. Yeah, I'm not sure if we want to spend money on that. Leather boots. Leather boots for traveling. Not good for combat, but a must for a long trip. Well, improves Marty. I wonder what Marty is wearing. Thank you, come again. Let's just see what he's wearing. Oh, he has leather boots. So I guess it would help his speed if he's had leather boots in both slots. That's weird though. I think we'll skip that. Thank you. leather cape. Thick cape made by animal hide offers some protection. I think for Marty, it's not a lot of money. Let's see what else there is. Red crystal. Crystal containing firepower inside. Increases resistance against fire attack. Green crystal. Contains wind power. Increased resistance against wind attack. Here's pet food, dried pet food, soft, crunchy pet food. Okay. Let's get the cape for Marty. It says thank you when you buy it. That's pretty cool. I don't know why. But I like that little detail. Avoidance goes up by 10. Seems worth it. Okay, this is where... Lumberer Victor says, I just checked deep into the woods. Their footprints are going off to the mountain path, so I'm sure they are heading towards the Ziziki cave. Marty says, just as the element leader gasped. Tessa says, what was the name of the woman ringleader of the gang? Fatima? She's scary. Is she really a woman? Muse says, she gives women a bad name. Since I am so ladylike, I want her to learn from me, says Muse. Everyone's... doesn't... like, is speechless. Why did you guys quiet all of a sudden? I'm sure Shannon is shaken up. I don't blame her since she was with such a scary woman. Go help her now, please. Bossy. Well, there's nobody in here. We've been in there. Oh, there's a green-haired person over here. Halleck says, I hate soldiers. I was stopped when I tried to leave the village, even though I wanted to go rescue Shannon. Miles says, leave Shannon to us. I promise that I'll bring her home safely. But will you do me a favor? What is it? I want you to protect this village until Shannon comes back. She'll be sad if she finds the village occupied again when she comes back, right? It's an important job. Okay, I'll guard the village. Good job, Miles, says Avin. Please save Shannon for me. I will protect the village. Alright, looks like that's the whole village. East is a sage's mansion. Huh, is that part of the village? Yeah. Alright, well maybe that's towards... Let's see... Prayer Woods? Sage's Mansion. Huh. And Ziki is back down that way. We'll see if we can get to the Mage's Mansion. They might not let us, but we'll see. Anyway, if not, in any case, I'm sure we're going to the Ziziki passage and cave next time. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.